Hi there, it's Taplink Team here, and in today's video, we're gonna be creating a small website for a fitness coach or a personal trainer. If you need a mini website for your Instagram bio that will have all links to your social networks, different ways to contact you, opt-in forms and so on, and you have never ever tried to create a website and you don't have any special skills like programming or designing, then consider using Taplink. It's the easiest and the most effective way to create your own mini website in 10-15 minutes. Also, you will be able to edit your mini website right from your mobile phone. Okay, so let's get started. The first thing you need to do is to go to the Taplink website and sign up. You should go right over here and click on sign in. Then you need to go right over here and click on sign up. As I already have an account, I will skip this step. You will see this page with a lot of ready-made templates that you can use. If you're not sure how your page should look like, you can use one of those templates. You can easily customize it for your own needs. But in this video, I'm gonna be creating a page from scratch, and for this purpose, I need to click on empty template. So, as in our previous video, we are creating a page for a personal brand. By the way, if you haven't watched our previous video, make sure you watch it next. So, we need to add some personal information like our first and last name, some information about what we do, what we specialize in, right? And our personal photo. So, the first thing I want to do is to remove this block. I should click on it and then click on action and delete. Okay, now I'm gonna add a headline with my first and last name. I'm gonna click add block, choose text, and then enter my first and last name. Then I choose center alignment and medium headline. Then I wanna add some extra information about what I do. So I click on add block again and choose text. And enter something like this: personal trainer that will help you transform your life. And again, I choose center alignment and medium text. Now, for my personal photo, I want to use a block called banner. As you can see, it's available on the Pro Rate plan. I'm gonna activate a 7-day free trial, so I click on show details and click on start a 7-day free trial. Then I go right over here and refresh the page. As you can see, now all blocks are available. So now I can use a block banner. I click on upload image and choose my personal photo. And then I click on save changes. Now, the main purpose of this page is to attract new customers, and I want to offer them a chance to try a workout for free to encourage them to contact me. So, for this purpose, I'm going to add a headline like first workout for free, and I'm going to choose center alignment and small headline, and then I click on save changes. Then I want to add some subtitle like want to start your fitness journey with me, and again I choose center alignment and click on save changes. And now I want to add a link to my WhatsApp with a call to action so people could contact me if they want to try a free workout. I'm gonna click on add block and choose messaging app. Then I choose WhatsApp, and here in this field I'm gonna add some text with a call to action like book a free workout. Then I need to enter my phone number, and in this field I can add a text message template so people don't have to think what to write. I'm gonna add something like hello, I would like to book a free workout, and then I click on save changes. Okay, this is my special offer for new customers. Now, I wanna tell people what I specialize in. So for this purpose, I'm gonna add a headline like what can I help you with, and choose center alignment and small headline. And then I'm gonna use a block called media and text. And there I'm gonna add my specializations. So the first one is building your workout routine. And here I can add an icon to this item. So in search, I'm gonna type in what I'm looking for and then choose an icon that I like. Then I'm gonna add a new item like making a meal plan and add an icon again. And then I repeat the process for other two items. and then I click on Save Changes. This is how it looks like. And again, I'm gonna add a link to my WhatsApp with some call to action so people could contact me easily. I click on Add Blog, choose Messaging app, choose WhatsApp, and then enter headline with the call to action like "You ready? Text me." Then again, I enter my phone number and click on Save Changes. Okay, the next thing I wanna add is some client success stories or testimonials or reviews. Customer testimonials help build trust and drive sales because people tend to trust other people. First, I'm gonna add a headline like "Stories of Success," and then I choose Central Alignment and Small Headline. And then I'm gonna use Image Carousel. I'm gonna add photos of my clients and their stories. So I'm gonna add 2 slides, I click on New Slide, and then I click on Upload Image and choose the first image. Then I click here and upload the second image. Now, I want to add some description to these photos of my clients. In the headline field, I'm going to add their name and their age. So this is Samantha and she's 25. In the description field, I'm going to add her story of success. In here, I will do the same. So in the headline field, I add a name and age and then some story of his success. And then I enable automatic slide transition and click on Save Changes. Okay, right after this block, I'm gonna add a headline like "Want the same results?" And then again, I'm gonna add different ways to contact me. It's a good idea to offer several ways to contact you because tastes differ and different people prefer using different methods. So in my case, I'm going to add a link to my phone and links to different messengers. So to add a link to my phone, I'm gonna click on Add Block and choose Link. In Action, I choose Call and then I enter my phone number. In the headline field, I'm gonna add something like "Call me," and then I can add a thumbnail and click Save Changes. Then I'm gonna add a small text like "Or send me a message," and add links to 3 different messengers. So I click on Add Block, choose Messaging app, and choose Facebook Messenger, WhatsApp, and Telegram. In Facebook Messenger, I enter my username. In WhatsApp, I enter my phone number. And in Telegram, I enter my username. And then I click on Save Changes. Now, I want to add the appearance of these 3 messengers. So I click on them and then click on Appearance and choose this placement. And then I click on Save Changes. Now, I want to add a section about me. I want to let people learn more about me and about what I do. So I click on Add Block, choose Text, add a headline about me, and then I wanna add my personal photo again. I click on Banner, upload image, and choose my photo. And then I wanna add some more information about myself. So I click on Add Block, choose Text, and add some extra information about myself. And I want to make it small. And then I click on Save Changes. I don't like how it looks like, so I'm gonna change it a little bit. I'm gonna move this piece of information to another line. And then I click on Save Changes. Yeah, much better. And then again, I want to add a link to my phone with a call to action so people don't forget what they should do if they want to start work with me. So I click on Add Block, choose Link. In the headline field, I'm gonna add something like "Book a free workout." In the action field, I choose Call and then I enter my phone number. And again, I add a thumbnail. And the last thing I want to add is my address with a map. So I'm going to click on Add Block, add a headline like "Find me here." And then I click on Add Block again and choose Map. And in this field, I'm going to add my address. And then I click on Add Marker and click on Save Changes. Okay, our page is almost ready. Now, I'm gonna add delimiters to separate pieces of content into clear groups. So I click on Add Block and choose Delimiter. Then I choose the size of the delimiter and its type, and then I click on Save Changes. I wanna place it right here. and then I can click on it and copy it. And then move it right here. And again, I click on it and then I click on duplicate and then move it right here. And repeat the process for other delimiters. Now let's change the design of the page. I'm gonna go to the design tab and then I choose a template that I like. I wanna have something with a black background, so I'm looking for a template with a black background. I think this is it, so I click on view, then scroll down and click on choose. Now I think that I want to change the color of different buttons, so I go to the design tab again and click on edit and then I click on yes. So we are now in design editor and here we can customize our design. In my case I want to choose the color of links, so I click on links and then in link background color I want to change the color from the black one to something like this. Okay, and I want to make a link transparent with a stroke and then I want to change the link title and link subtitle color to the same color. Okay, and then I click on save changes. And then I go back to the page and I see that nothing has changed. So I go to the design tab again, go to my designs, click on the create a design, click on view, scroll down, and I see that some links have changed. And I click on choose. Then I go to the page again, click on the WhatsApp button, click on the appearance and choose design, so it is changed too. Then I click on save changes. Then again, I click on this WhatsApp button, click on appearance, choose design and click on save changes. And the same for these three messengers. Okay, looks good. And the last thing I want to do is to change the background of some blocks. For example, I want to change the background for these blocks and for these blocks. And for example, for this map block. For this purpose, I should go to the design tab again, go to the created design and click on edit. Here, I should choose add section. Let it be primary section and then I click on add. In this section I want to have a little bit different background, so I click on background color and change the color to another one. And then I choose padding for my section and then I want to make links in this section filled with color. So I remove link transparency and then change the color of link title and link subtitle. Yes, something like this and then I click on save changes. Now I go to the page and choose a block I want to have with a different background. So I click here for example, choose section and then I choose primary section that I just created in the design tab. And then I click on save changes. Okay, and then I need to expand this section. And again for other blocks, I click on a block, choose section, choose primary section and then I click on save changes. And then I need to expand the section for the blocks I need. In my case, it'll be these blocks. And the last one, I want to add a section here, so I do the same. Okay, our page is ready. Now we need to get a link to our page. We should click on publish and type in our username. In my case, it'll be personal trainer, and then I should click on connect. That's it, this is your website link. You should copy it and then paste it to your Instagram bio or to any social networks that you need. Alright, this is our website for a fitness coach or a personal trainer. Do you like it? Would you like to create something similar? And also, if you have any questions, please let us know in the comments below. Also, if you enjoyed this video, please be sure to give it a thumb up and subscribe to this channel. Bye!